start with 3.1, new business, there is none. 3.2, our minutes from our April 6th, May 23rd, special board meetings, I've not seen any errors with those. 3.3, our finance report. You can see, we have two attachments. The first is our investment report. David Manning takes care of all the school investments and those appear to be up to date. The second attachment I'd like to, for you to open, it is our, it's titled State Aid FY21 Previous Year Chargeables. That is just a year to date, April to April, from FY19 to FY20. You can see from that chart, we're down over $1 million in our gross production, in our REA tax, and in our school land earnings. So a total of our local revenue is down 1.1 million. So that's really probably not a surprise. We all know the economic impact that COVID-19 has had. It's certainly impacted our district and our local revenue. Just to give you an update from a financial standpoint at the state, it appears that they're going to try to hold education harmless, but I just received an email that it looks like there will be some cuts, anywhere in the neighborhood from 2 to 4%. And that can also change because as enrollment increases in the school, when the schools go back on the formula, it decreases that amount. So a lot of unknowns, a lot of uncertainty, but something we continue to monitor. Approval of the activity fund report. Our April and FY for the year-to-date activity fund report really has not been much change from last month. Very little activity right now. Mrs. Durkee is wrapping up fundraisers, getting deposits in. There were a few things that were outstanding prior to our break. No fundraisers for 3.5, 3.6, inter-account transfers. Have two inter-account transfers. The first is our date for basketball. So that's a percentage of use, and that use distributed out to each sport. You can see that distribution there on the attachment. The second attachment is our distribution. Or actually, I guess it's all on one. Scroll down. It's done by Alva Middle School Activity Account. So the student council would work two concession stands. When they work a concession stand, they get $100 for working that concession stand. So you can see student council received 200, biz kids received 200, and TSA for the concession stand, and FCC LA. So it's been a good opportunity for those students. Some real world experience and also about their activity accounts. Child nutrition report, our food service. Just wanted to kind of point out to you on this spreadsheet, this shows our totals. Since we've had the school closure, I want to recognize our cooks. This is they've done an outstanding job. We have delivered on average about 240 to 250 meals a day, served about 340 meals a day. So our cooks and our support staff, and even in the beginning we had volunteers, they've just done a fantastic job. So I want to thank all of them for their hard work. And then on 3.8, we do not have any items in surplus. Any questions on the consent agenda? There are none, I would recommend it's approved.
See,
That is for our contracted occupational therapy services. That will continue through the summer as part of our extended school year services and as required federally and state continuing services. 629 in Jocelyn's, that is for diplomas. And 630 is Mayfield America, Red Building, and that's the people on that side. We have a few purchase orders from our payroll. Substitute pay that we had right before the school closing. We have nothing out of our building fund that was purchased this month, nothing out of child nutrition, nothing out of our building. Are there any questions from 4.1, our general fund? So all instruction has been virtual. And the state provided quite a few resources for our special ed director and for occupational therapists and physical therapists. So we continue to provide those all virtually. And then we also have paraprofessionals that support those services virtually. And we will continue that, as you'll see later on in the meeting.
Hanson?
Yes.
Kane?
Yes.
McDermott?
Yes.
Parker?
Yes.
Slater?
Yes.
Okay, 5.1, we don't have any resignations, retirements, or reassignments. We just want to talk to y'all a little bit about 5.2, my communication. It's obviously continues to be a really fluid situation as far as summer reading academy. We've had questions about summer driver's ed. Had questions about sports games, and we don't have any directives yet on what those guidance and what that would look like. I can tell you that we received an email today from the Secondary Activities Association that school facilities would remain closed to the uniform. So as we get those directives and we're able to communicate with staff, coaches, and sponsors, we'll make sure that there's a special meeting or through our team. That's an opportunity to vet through those games, driver's ed, or some of the other examples. Any questions? That's all.
Discussion with possible board action. Vote to appoint certified teachers listed on the agenda.
Okay, Exhibit 8, that list of teachers are considered career teachers. They have all been teachers for over 4 semesters, and that's what makes them career teachers. And I would recommend their approval for the 2021 school year.
Hanson?
Yes.
Kane?
Yes.
McDermott?
Aye.
Parker?
Yes.
Slater?
Yes.
Discussion with possible board action. Vote to employ certified teachers listed on Exhibit B on temporary contract for 2021 school year.
Temporary contract employees, these contracts expire on the last day of our school year next year. Signed the contract for the administrator, and I would recommend that we approve these following teachers based on Exhibit B on a temporary contract for 2021 school year.
Slater?
Yes.
Parker?
Yes.
McDermott?
they really went through the fire because we started this process and the school closure. They hung in there. I think they were fine. We saw better. But I want to introduce, first of all, our applicant, Lungie Webster. She comes for us from Cherokee. She's a former third grade teacher here in Alva. Daughter that would be at Northwestern running cross country.
Track and cheer.
Okay, that's right. And then a daughter that will be in seventh grade. So we are excited to welcome Jeannie to our community. We're having her applicant number two. Corey Smith comes to us from Hugo. Corey, help me out now. Okay. Seven children, correct?
Correct.
Three school age and three and under, correct? And one out of school. And so Corey brings 12 years of education experience. Also was an active in the U.S. Navy, originally from Anoka. We are very excited to have Corey and happy to be a part of our community. Again, I want to tell the board and thank our committee, the principals. We had two rounds of interviews, and these two really rose to the top, and I'm excited and happy to have you.
Love our hearing. Hanson.
Yes.
Kane.
Yes.
McDermott.
Aye.
Parker.
Yes.
Slater. McDermott.
Aye.
Kane.
Yes.
Hanson.
Yes.
Slater.
Thank you.